good day, all of you. Dave, yourself, Bulandelic Ultra. We continue with this topic of Stanisław Lem, whose year we are currently celebrating. And we're all very happy about it because he was a wonderful author, but also a wonderful mind. And with me is Marek Kundzielski, a Polish philosopher, but also a huge fan of Stanisław Lem. Thank you again for coming.
Thank you for inviting me. And yes, absolutely, Stanisław Lem is present in my intellectual life from very early moments, let's say.
And so let's talk a little bit right now about his technical achievements. So in way of practical achievements in predicting some of the technological development, because Stanisław Lem is such a unique author who were able to foresee the future. Many tried to do it. A lot of the ideas were absolutely unreal, but Lem had the intuition of which will be the direction the world develops itself.
Yes, this is very true. I think he has an absolutely unique understanding of the deployment of technology and understanding what is our real future and what is not. For instance, in the times when he was writing his futurological works, people commonly believe that we are going to the stars, that we will build starships and will explore the universe, which has not happened. We are on the eve on this interplanetary period in our development, probably, mostly thanks to competition between China and the United States and Russia. But this is only now. And for years, our technological development ran into completely another direction. And Lem foresaw not only the direction, but specific achievements. And this is what I was presenting during this Tata Literature Festival to Indian spectators and viewers. And they were absolutely astonished. If you take, for instance, and we are in the beginning of the 60s, when he is writing, because he managed to predict the future and the development in the technology that is included equally in his novels and short stories from one side and in his fundamental works like Dialogues and Summa Technologiae, which are entirely dedicated to the deployment of technology. But to point some examples, for instance, he managed to predict e-book readers. And this is absolutely astonishing, not only the facts, but the way he describes it. So let me have a quotation, because I don't have entire quotation in my mind. But you can read, the books were crystals with recorded contents. They can be read with the aid of an option, which was similar to a book, but had only one page between the covers. At a touch, successive pages of the text appeared on it.
It's absolutely that.
This is absolutely, but this is published.
Exactly.
This is published in 1961. And at that time.
As if he actually has seen the reader.
Yes. We didn't have anything of the devices we are not surrendered with. We didn't have computers. We didn't have telephones. We didn't have internet. We didn't even have any digital devices. They were all analog. So, and the computers were huge as the wardrobes and stored in big air-conditioned rooms. And their capacity was smaller than the capacity of a calculator you can buy in any shop that the kids buy for school.
Right now.
Yes, they are using at school. He also predicted audiobooks. He predicted computer games. He predicted internet. He was convinced that computers will be combined in huge international and intercontinental networks. They will exchange resources. He predicted smartphones, three-dimensional printers. So very many specific achievements in technology. And this is absolutely astonishing. So you can see that he understands how we are able to explore the nature and which technological achievements can be put into practice and in what way.
So he understood the not only the world as it was in the 1960s, but in which are the basically the doors in order to develop which way, and which way the world and our knowledge and capacity can go. And that's mostly to the passing through the information which he has seen, because all of this is the computer games, the audiobooks, the smartphones, the Wi-Fi. It's in fact this need of a human being to pass information quicker, shorter to each other and be more connected. And that's what he's seen.
Yes. So, for instance, he has foreseen not only the internet as a computer net combined with each other between the continents, but also huge internet resources that anybody can have access to. He also predicted that we'll be putting everything into internet that we have at hand, and 90% of this will be garbage. So this is exactly how human nature works, and he was aware of that.
So it's all very actually also interesting, but I would say challenging, and in a way there is a deep feeling of unaware and distress when you listen to it. Yes, Stanisław Lem so well understood the human nature. And of course, to you, the viewers of Poland Daily, if you want to have if you want to travel to the future and have a look in which way the world will develop, maybe you can read it out of the books of Stanisław Lem, because he has seen so much. And I'm sure that there is even more in his books, which still didn't happen yet, but will. And thank you very much for watching Poland Daily.